Hello guys, welcome to this another project video. In this project video, we are going to do another project called square root calculator. Here, this is the previous code where we have used it to calculate the factorial of a number. If you not saw that video, go and check out in the playlist under Python Tkinter projects. You can get a code for the factorial calculator. In order to do a square root calculator, first of all, it's simple to do if you learn a calculator using a factorial. Just you want to change the operation of factorial with the operation of square root. Okay, now if we change the title for it as sqrt of a number, then let me change some labels here. Already a square root calculator I have wrote here. Then let me change like okay. Now here we want to change the operation of a factorial to operation of a square root. In order to do that, it's simple, take a factorial out and insert square root. Now whenever I click a button, here the button is B, whenever I click a button, the command will call the call function. Now the command will jump to this call function, then t is equal to e dot get. This means it get input from the entry attribute. Okay, then it will convert. Basically this output t is equal to e dot get will be in the form of string. It will convert this string into integer, which is again stored in the same variable called t. Then this integer will be converted into square root. Now we want to update in the result label, right? So in order to update it, I am just using this one line code called result.config. I am just configuring it the old text with text is equal to math dot square root of t. Now let's see the output of this project. This is the output where this is the entry box. If I am entering a number called 2, then this t will get the input 2 from this entry box. That means now t is equal to 2, which is in the form of string. Now we cannot use this string to do the operation of square root, right? So I am just converting this string into integer. Now I want to update this output value. Whenever I click a button, the output value will be updated in the result label. Okay, in order to update this result by the value, I am just using this small line code called result.config of text is equal to math dot square root of t. Now the text result will be updated by the square root of this input value. Now I will click this button. Now this 2 will be in t. Whenever I click this button, the function will call this call, then the t will get 2. Now the 2 will be in the form of string. Now I am just converting it to integer. Then I am just updating this result with the math dot square root. Now let me check. It actually gives a very big value, which is an accurate value, but let me approximate this value to 2 decimal. Okay, in order to do that, we want to just use this simple code or identifier percentage point to f. Then outside percentage. Now this math dot square root will be approximated to the 2 decimal. I'm just using f here because the square root of a number gives a float value, right? This percentage point to f you could learn in the Python, right? You can use this here. Actually this Python Tkinter is just for an interface for the persons or for the users. You can use all the basics of Python here to build your actionable project, right? Now let me try it. Yes, now let me try with the same value 2. When I it's calculated like 1.41, which means it gives only the 2 decimal value. Now when I give 1, it gives 1.00. okay, now let me try with 4, it gives 2.00. okay, this is the output. You can also try this on your own. It's simple, guys. Just learn the basics of using a label options and also some widgets in Tkinter. Then you can also able to create your own application. I'm also posted around 17 videos in this same YouTube channel under the playlist of Python Tkinter tutorials. If you want, you can learn from this. That and you can build your own user interface. One life, be happy. Stay tuned for the next video.